We know through our statistics that 10% of us will die of a sudden event, the sudden heart attack, stroke, something, car accident. But the rest of us, 90%, are going to have some kind of prolonged illness. Even with that, just through the natural process of dying, there's very often this quiet time where the patient may be unresponsive most of the time, if not all of the time. And for many healthcare professionals and the family, that's often the hardest time. Because you think about before that time, there's always something happening. There might be symptom issues. You're dealing with somebody's pain or other symptoms. They're thinking about treatment. Something's going on to keep people occupied and busy. It's when this everything's calm and very quiet is sometimes the most challenging time for families. That's a time where we'll often get the question, you know, it's hard to see our mom or dad or family member suffering like this when they may be lying in bed sleeping very comfortably, but it's just all that emotional pain catching up with the family, and they now have time to sit and just be very present with it and very conscious of it. And the suffering generally is more their own, going through this dying process with their loved one. So it's hard to do nothing at that time. So it can be such a special time, and we've had family members say that so much that they couldn't believe how special the time was. You know, it sounds strange, but at times we'll talk about the amazing time of being around when a new life is being born and how special it is and how you remember that for the rest of your life. The reality is, it really is the same at the end of life, that for those around, it has that potential to be that special a time, special in a different way, obviously, but it's something that people will remember for the rest of their lives, which is why it's so important for us and the patient and the family to work together as well as we can to allow somebody to have a good death, because it has such a long-standing impact. It's the same we all hear. Anybody that's had kids have met the mom who's had the horrendous birth experience and labor, and we'll talk about that ad nauseum sometimes, frightening everybody else around them. It's the same thing at the end of life. If somebody's had a not so good death, an uncomfortable death, and a death in turmoil, you know, that's what they'll remember, and that's what they'll anticipate is going to be. You know, if it's a family member, that's what they're going to anticipate is going to be their end, and that's what it's going to look like when it doesn't need to be that way. Family will often quietly to themselves think, I wish my mom or dad, whomever, would die soon. And then very quickly after that, they feel guilty for thinking such a thing. So it's something that we'll often bring up to family, that this is a pretty normal thing for people to think about, because you've seen your loved one go through the illness process, and you just want it to be over for them so that they can be at peace. Again, many people have found that reassuring to know that it's not unusual to be thinking that, because they feel quite guilty for thinking such a thing. But we reassure them that you're thinking that because you love the person and you want them to be at peace. And it's okay to feel that way. So much of what we do is help people understand what's normal. We have a booklet that we've called The Last Hours and Days of Life that we provide to family members when somebody's kind of actively dying in the last hours and days of life. That goes through a lot of the physical things that you can witness, but also even some of the social things, how most people's circles will get smaller and smaller, and by that I mean how many people they want, who they actually want to be kind of at the bedside with them, which gets to be a challenge for families and patients for pure exhaustion purposes. They could have friends from 40 years ago wanting to come see them, which is wonderful. However, if they only have so much energy, they want to make sure they can spend that with those that are closest with them. So helping families to understand the normal things that people will go through. They want fewer people coming in, sometimes for shorter periods of time, the room to be quieter sometimes, but also understanding the physical changes that they can go through, the changes in breathing pattern, the changes in you know, sleep and awake times, the chance for some restlessness or a little bit of confusion. All of those things, it's important for families to understand what's normal, or even if something is not comfortable for the person, what we can do to help that. Having that knowledge helps the family feel so much more at ease and able to be present without being afraid.